When we talk of the culinary scene here in the Bay Area, you have to mention the city of Oakland. My cousins would be very proud, right? With such a diverse food scene, it is considered one of the best cities to find new tastes. And joining us right now is Oakland's own celebrity chef and author, Renee Johnson. She's got a whole bunch of like really super fun stuff. Renee, so tell me a little bit about what we have right now.
So what we have right now, first of all, let me say thank you so much for having me and letting me be able to talk about who I am and share what I have going on. It's such a pleasure. But what I have for you this morning is I have one of our signature homemade biscuits topped with a little bit of blackberry compote, fresh blackberries. Mm. And then I have one of our most requested menu items, a sweet potato waffle with a little bit of fried chicken, which is what we're going to showcase at our Soul Food Stroll on August the 18th.
Very nice. Where are you guys located again?
We're at 408 12th Street, downtown Oakland.
Okay, got it.
That's where we are. And I own a company called Blackberry Soul Fine Catering.
Okay.
I've had it now for 15 years, and
wow.
We're based out of the Bay Area.
Yeah.
So we fed every single body that you guys probably know and met and love.
Wow. I mean, we were going over, while Kathy was talking, we were going over the cookbook. When did you guys put this together? And is this something that we could purchase if we go down to?
Absolutely. Okay. That cookbook is about 5 years old. What I decided to do when I made that cookbook, it was when COVID happened.
Yeah.
And I was trying to figure out how to make sure that Blackberry Soul stayed in everybody's house.
Yeah.
And so I decided that I would make a cookbook.
You were spreading the love.
Yes. And so we, you know, I was at home, we're stranded at home, and so we started making a cookbook, and it has most of all of our clients' favorite recipes in there, our collard greens, our cornbread.
Our cornbread is a big deal.
Our mac and cheese.
Now, do you like honey with your cornbread?
No, girl.
My family's from Texas, and we do a lot of honey and cornbread.
You guys do honey and cornbread.
I know. Creamed honey.
Right.
You do honey.
We do a hot water cornbread.
Yes.
We also do a pineapple upside down cornbread.
Ooh.
Which takes cornbread to a whole nother funky level. It's just an experience that everybody needs to have inside their mouth.
So what, from your perspective, makes Oakland unique? I mean, we have long appreciated the diverse aspect of Oakland. So why do you think, from a taste perspective, is it so fundamentally important?
I think that Oakland, we were just talking about Oakland, being born and raised, me and my mother had the same kindergarten teacher. That's how deep Oakland is in
for me.
And I think that what Oakland brings to us is that Oakland, especially right now, we still keep the soul of soul food.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we keep all of our grandmother's traditional recipes. Right now, with the way the world is, we've just elevated that just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping it fresh, keeping it live, sourcing things from the Bay Area. It's just a way for us to bring our community together. You know, food brings us together anyway.
Right.
You know, food makes friends. Music and food make friends.
Yeah.
So with Oakland is a place where you can experience almost every cuisine, and it's always good.
Yeah.
You know, I've traveled everywhere, and when I come home, it's a whole nother situation. I was just talking to somebody about biscuits in Georgia and biscuits here. And you know, and it's different. You know, like even in the South, there's a Hoppin' John, but we do hot water cornbread.
Yeah.
So it's just different. I think that Oakland brings people together on all levels, no matter what color we are, no matter where our journey is.
Mm-hmm.
If you're from Oakland, you got this little vibe to you.
Yeah.
And our food has a vibe.
What inspires you when you are looking at making a dish and so forth? I mean, you were sharing your son is your taste tester. What really kind of goes through your head as you're, I mean, do you walk through farmers markets to get inspired?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
My thing is that I'm always channeling both of my grandmothers. I'm the first grandbaby to my mother's mother. And she made everything we touched.
Mm.
So, you know, she gave the chicken she raised it, the butter, Everything we touch, we taste, she made. So I channel her often.
Mm.
But the other thing about it, my thing is that every time somebody takes a bite of some of my food, I want them to have a whole different funky experience. You know, I want it to be an experience that makes you want to do a cartwheel. I'm known as a chef that says, only thing I require from you guys is a kiss and for you to make a lot of noise when you eat my food.
I'm going to take that to my daughter tonight. What would you give a message to people that are looking to dive into, to kind of put their foot into the craft of cooking, of serving community?
I love people to be brave. My thing is, and I have shared my craft and my vision with a lot of chefs in the Bay Area. I have been an entrepreneur for 30 years, and I've had Blackberry Soul for 15 years. And I want people to know that you are going to go through peaks and valleys. But when you...
That's life.
And just because I feel like it takes courage to wake up every day and do any business to know that you're going to have enough clients, to know you're going to have enough money to pay your bills and take care of your staff. And for me, buy my granddaughter a princess dress when she calls me and says, Grandma, I love you. Can you send me a princess dress?
Aww.
I want to be able to do that. So I want people to know that there's peaks and valleys, but to trust and believe in your craft and your vision and always have support. I can't do anything without my team and without
my
family.
We can talk about faith, right?
Yes, to and having faith. Prayer is everything. Yeah. Every morning I say, I give it to you. And I don't take it back. But I also know that without my team, without my mother praying, without my family, without my team being here, I'm nothing. So make sure you have a crew. Make sure you have somebody to believe
in. Faith in your people, the whole
thing. Yes, absolutely. And know that it's okay to go through peaks and valleys. Because so right now, I think that we always see the fun part. We don't see the part where, you know, you're up all
night.
Hard
stuff.
Right. Yeah. Right. Exactly.
Sometimes I think we should just share the hard stuff so that people just get a better impression of the reality of life.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I also think that you need to know that nobody wakes up and is perfect.
Yeah. You should have seen me a couple hours ago. Anyway, we'll leave it at that.
I just told you how cute you are, okay? I said, I'm so glad you're easy to look at. She told me, look at me. And I said, ooh, you're cute, so I could do this.
Anyway, I embarrass easily. So we're going to wrap it. Thank you very much, Renee. We're going to have a lot more coming up on the Cropper Morning News on this Sunday, as I blush.
I just wanted to tell everybody.